Hi again, this is ABCs of Anesthesia, and in this series, I'm going through just the best resources that I found as a junior anaesthetist. So this one, we're gonna go through the best websites and the best journals. And the reason I'm doing that is really, I found that there's just really three really amazing websites that I go to constantly and one journal that you need to know about when you're training. So let's get started. As always, I don't have any sponsors or affiliations or incentives for this, and these websites are purely my opinion. Now, one of those websites is my personal website for education, and this is anesthesiacollective.com, and we'll put the link down there. But also the fact that this website is pretty much where I'll, you know, launch most of my things as a one-stop resource for the stuff that we're doing with podcasts and YouTube, as well as the online courses and online sessions. And I'll do another video about everything that we're offering on that website soon. But so that's anesthesiacollective.com. But let's get onto these other two websites that I find really, really useful for just the sheer amount of knowledge that they have. The first one I want to talk about is Life in the Fastlane, and there's a link just over there. So that's litfl.com, lifeinthefastlane.com. Now, this is just an incredible website. Mainly, well, first of all, it's run by an Australasian team, including this fantastic intensivist called Chris Nixon, and he actually just works down the road from me here. And they've just set up this amazing free open access medical education platform here. You know, this is part of that Foment philosophy where they have free education, and just this is just such an incredible resource. Now, if you go to the website, you'll see that there's just so many things there. So, for example, if I ever need to just need a brief summary of something, I'll just get on my phone and just Google it, and often Life in the Fastlane will be one of the top hits. It's just such a great resource. It's got not just lots of good information that's referenced, but it also has a lot of good tacit knowledge as well. Just the experience of people who've worked in critical care, anesthesia, emergency, and intensive care. And I find that this is just a really good one-stop shop for a lot of really useful information. So if I just go to the homepage, first of all, they've got, you know, Life in the Fastlane libraries. And they've got a whole bunch of things of investigations, the ECG library, as well as updates on coronavirus, toxicology. So very emergency focused, but also they have like their own ECG course as well. So I find this incredibly useful. You'll see that they've linked to a couple of podcasts as well as collections. And again, just a really fantastic resource, lifeinthefastlane.com. So one of the particularly good resources they have is the Critical Care Compendium. So you'll see there's CCC at the top of their menu. And if you go to that, it literally has this collection of pages, and what they say is it concisely covers core topics. That's a whole bunch of C's there. So Critical Care Compendium, comprehensive collection, concisely covering core topics and controversy in critical care. I don't think they did that by accident. So for example, if you want to know about AA gradient, that's the first thing that comes up here. And it gives a really fantastic little summary of AA gradient, and you know, everything you need to know in an absolute nutshell. And I like to think this is the way a lot of us like to teach. We like to give you the absolute basics of how an anaesthetist or a specialist would think about something in practice. And I think this team here just does that to perfection. And you know, I find this an incredibly good resource. So the next website is anaesthesiauk.com. Now, this is, again, so it's a UK-based website. Again, a really great resource. It's very UK-centric, so there's a lot of things that are useful for anyone who's trying to get through the part one and final exams in the United Kingdom, as well as get jobs in the United Kingdom. Again, a really great resource with, you know, even interview questions, as well as your part one information and part two information. And again, a great resource because, you know, if you were to go down to intensive care, for example, you've got all the different topics here that it covers, critical care in the UK, respiratory, sepsis, nutrition, ethics, renal physiology, hematology, neuroscience, etc. So in the left-hand panel there, they have a section called resources. And again, really great summaries for anatomy, clinical anesthesia, physics and equipment, pharmacology, even a medical legal resource, renal respiratory stats, and a couple of podcasts as well. So I find I use this resource as, again, one of the major resources that I found useful. Now, the final website I want to talk about is actually a journal website. So there are so many high impact journals out there. There's a British Journal of Anesthesia, Anesthesiology, Anesthesia Intensive Care is our local Australian journal. So many impressive journals from around the world, from Europe, from the Americas, etc. But there's one journal article or journal that I think you absolutely need to know about as a trainee. For example, most of the time you might read journals and they have these, you know, really niche randomized control trials about a very specific topic. And often they might have some interesting findings or they might have some negative findings, but they don't always change practice. So reading these journals that are very high impact wasn't always the best use of my time. Now, BJED is very different. So this is bjaed.org, and we'll put the link just there. I'll put all the links in the story notes below as well. And what's really impressive about this is literally it is just a journal article full of review articles, and that's pretty much what you want. So they have specialists and trainees compiling some of the best knowledge from various other papers, journals, research, and references, and they're compiling together in a really succinct format. So how would I use this? For example, they go through all the things that affect clinical anesthesia, where it's specific kinds of surgeries, specific pathologies, specific crises and complications in anesthesia, and anything that's topical. Pick up any of these journals and start reading it from the BJED series, and there'll be something interesting in there. But let's say the next day or the next week, I'm about to have a very interesting case. Maybe it's a pheochromocytoma, maybe it's a patient with a subarachnoid hemorrhage, or whatever it is. Maybe it's a liver resection, fixed thoracics operation, or even just pneumoperitoneum for a laparoscopic cholecystectomy. I could literally just search in this journal article, this journal right now, and find a resource that was all about that. And it would also be the summary of it. So I'd just look at that summary, I'd have a read, and that way I could have a really good insight into what was about to happen for that operation as a junior, but even as a senior, it's a great refresher. So a lot of the notes that I took for my final exam were straight from this series of articles, because they're already such amazing, concise articles. So I'd almost go this in preference. In the textbook, the three best textbook video that I put out, I said Clinical Anesthesiology by Morgan McHale, fantastic textbook. It's almost like this is that on steroids, and also just as concise, but probably better reference with more late evidence or more recent evidence. So that's probably the best tip I can give you. Those, the textbooks and the websites are all very useful, but if you want to go to that next level, this is the first set of articles you need to go to, because it'll give you that extra information that's completely valuable. Now, the level after this is definitely to start reading papers. And, some of the most knowledgeable nieces I know, they would read a paper a day just as part of their routine, just to keep on top of what the latest research and latest evidence was. But this does a really good job of summarizing it while you're a junior and you're still learning the ropes. So I hope you enjoyed that. I hope that was useful. So in summary, Life in the Fastlane, AnesthesiaUK.com, and the BJ Education Series journal articles. Fantastic resources. I hope you find this useful. So please share with anyone who might be interested. And thanks for all your support.